previously on Back of the Backlog.
It's this long-nosed little bitch.
Whoa, you know what? I want to talk to you.
Kylo, we got a fucking problem.
I see you. I see you treating him horribly.
I thought I was your friend.
Kylo was just going to go home now.
Since I knew you were feeling like this, I wanted to give you a new game.
Star Wars Episode 8, The Last Jedi movie review.
Robert, are you even listening?
Yeah. Kinda. Okay, not really. What happened?
You thinking about Kylo?
What?
I said, are you thinking about Kylo?
No. I heard you. I'm just saying, like, why do you think that? Why would you think I'm thinking about him?
Well, you've been wandering off every so often this past month.
Doesn't mean I'm thinking about him.
All right, I'm just asking.
Okay, fine. I was thinking about him. Is that so fucking bad?
No, it's fine, Holy Rob. Shit, it's fine. Big it's deal? Fine.
Really?
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with thinking about your friend that you haven't seen in a month, how he's doing.
I just maybe think I should contact him. But then I remind myself that he's the one in the wrong. He's the one that should apologize. And I think it shows true colors that he still hasn't.
Yeah, well, that's Kylo for you.
And now back to Keeping Up with the Amiibos.
Oh my god. Everybody's got a fucking reality show now.
I thought you were the same person, Mario, I'm telling you.
Bullshit! You know that we're the same person, I tell you that all the fucking time. He's a doctor, and I'm a regular fucking plumber. When you said you were going to marry me, you said you knew the difference between us.
Mario, will you just shut the fuck up and listen to me? Holy
Now you shut the fuck up! I loved you, and I thought you loved me.
Hate to say it, but she told me I'd have a bigger than you, motherfucker. I see a future, and it's my fucking you, Peach.
Oh, Shulk, it's been such a minute. I've been wanting to fuck you for so long.
What the fuck? I don't understand. First, Dr. Mario, and then Shulk.
Well, maybe if you got even half as much money as Dr. Mario.
Peach, when can I give you my blue? I've been waiting for so much. It's been a long time.
And what the fuck? You're telling me you've been also Moth? This is a nightmare. This is a nightmare.
Mario, I swear I will slap your ass, motherfucker.
I'm back at the backlog. Been gone for way too long. I'm back at the backlog. Got so many games to play, dog. I'm back at the backlog. Donkey Kong explains my dog. I'm back at the backlog. Me and Kylo been fucking since dawn. I'm back at the backlog. Did you know that Kylo wears thongs? I'm back at the backlog. I really fucking hate this song.
Get out of here, bitch!
What is up, guys? It is Robert of GamingWithMe, and welcome to episode 3 of Back at the Backlog. Today, we're going to be talking about the game that I got off my backlog, Bully. Bully was a game I've always wanted to actually play, But, I mean, just never really got around to actually play it. I picked it up back, I want to say 2015. I don't know the exact year, but it's probably around then. My only history with the game is the fact that I saw a Let's Play of it from PewDiePie back in, well, before I made this channel. So that had to be at, like, 2012. And that's literally the only background I have with the history I have of this game. Regardless, Bully was released on the PS2 first in the US on October 17th, 2006. It was then re-released as Bully Scholarship Edition with better graphics on the Wii and the Xbox 360 on March 4th, 2008, with a PC release on October 24th, 2008. It was also released on PS3 on December 18th, 2012 and March 22nd, 2016 on PS4. So which version did I play? The updated HD graphics of the 360 and the PS3 and the PS4 or the almighty PC or some cool Wii shit? No. I played the PS2. Even though I had all those options, you know, picked up in like 2015. Had every other option I could think of. I picked it up on the PS2. I don't know why. Bully was developed by Rockstar Games Vancouver and published by Rockstar Games. Rockstar is obviously known for their Grand Theft Auto franchise, so it isn't too surprising knowing this game would be a target of controversy. I mean, from an ignorant outsider perspective, you see the name Bully, see the gameplay beating up kids in school. Doesn't seem too good of an image for Rockstar. So much in fact that the name was changed in Europe, UK, and Australia to Canis Canem Edit, which is Latin for dog eat dog. Protests for Bully to even be sold was happening. Everything in the game was looked at as if it was under a microscope. Even going as far as to saying, well, the main character could kiss a guy, so that should be censored. And Rockstar Game came back saying, what's wrong with homosexuality? Good on them! If your big problem is that the character could kiss a dude, fuck you, holy shit. Was all that controversy worth it in the slightest? No, of course not. Anyway, let's talk about Bully. Let's first talk about the story. It's a simple yet funny story about a 15-year-old kid named Jimmy Hopkins who has been expelled from every school around him and is being forced to go to Bulworth Academy. Now, Bulworth Academy is literally the worst school. Everyone is a dick, and so Jimmy kind of tries to get the school straightened up by also kind of technically being a dick too. Jimmy meets this guy named Gary, and Gary betrays him, and he eventually becomes the villain of Bully. It's a funny story where you'll meet several cliques in the school trying to get everyone united as one team.
When I went to school, I honestly was a bully.
You? Really? That's surprising considering how nice you are.
Yes, well, I would meditate a lot to get rid of my aggression towards fucking idiots! Like you said, I'm very nice now.
Yeah. Go meditation. There's a lot of funny cutscenes with a ton of different character interactions. What really propels the story is the well-written dialogue for the characters. Each character is based on stereotypes in a school like the jocks, the nerds, the preppies, the bullies, and the greasers. Visually, Bully by now is pretty dated, even in terms of its remaster. That's not to say it looks bad, but it being on the PS2 and all, it can look blurry. It doesn't bother me at all, but it just shows that realism and graphics don't age very well. The frame rate dips pretty often, not to the point where it ruins the game at all, but it is very noticeable. Bully's setup is similar to Grand Theft Auto, where you'll go to locations throughout the map, complete a mission, and then return back to your safe spot, which is the dorm. However, in Bully, you are a part of a school, so that means you to also take classes alongside the story missions. These classes aren't mandatory, but help you in certain ways, like for example, completing shop classes grants you better BMX bikes. There are certain times when classes are available. You can skip classes, but the security around the school will chase you down and take you to class if they see you. I didn't mind going to classes, even if they are technically kind of minor distractions. I didn't do every single one of the classes, like for instance, English. I was pretty garbage at that. English is basically a bunch of scrambled letters and you have to make words out of them. And I was just awful at that. Oh my God.
English was actually always my best subject.
Oh yeah? I could see that.
See what?
that English is your best subject.
How can you see that?
No, it's just an expression.
Yeah, okay. Sounds like a failure to me.
Whoa, okay, someone's a little moody today. I'm not a huge fan of side stuff in games in general because they, a lot of the time, seem like an afterthought compared to the main story. But Bully's side quests are just as fun as the main missions. All have complete cutscenes and for the most part, unique feeling objectives. And since this is an open world game, it is fun to be a damn bully and start fights with random people and start running to your dorm because you're getting chased by a security guard, and you get to the dorm right as you're about to get picked up by one of the security guards, and it's so funny, it makes me hysterically laugh every single goddamn time. What you could do in the world is a lot more limited than compared to Grand Theft Auto, but I still had like a few hours of just bullshitting, and that's always a fun time. The main story is divided into 5 chapters. Each chapter is Jimmy taking on a new clique. Meeting new characters in each chapter isn't a headache because they let you have the time to hear each character and what they're going through. None of it is truly serious, but instead funny and very over the top. The missions have a lot of variety and personality given to them. One mission will have you find an alcoholic teacher's bottles, while another will take you to a hidden fort in the school where the nerds have this fucking giant machine gun that shoots potatoes instead of bullets. It's great because no two missions feel the same, which was a worry of mine before I started playing. My only gripe with missions is that if you lose, you start from the beginning, which would be fine if you actually restarted the mission, but no. You have to normally go to sleep to start a new day, and then go to the location of the mission, and then start it up. Doing that even a few times can start to get to you. It's not only until chapter 5 that I felt a shift in quality. Not that the missions were bad, but they felt a lot more rushed than the rest of the game. It's especially apparent when it's one of the more longer chapters, but those final missions are pretty short, and the whole lead up to the final boss just feels like a throwaway. It ends with a final showdown that, in my opinion, was pretty disappointing. It's just a normal fistfight with Gary. You're on some construction on the school, and the more you hit Gary, the more layers of construction you go through. It just ends with Gary and Jimmy breaking through the principal's office, and that's it. Just a normal fist fight. You go through so many missions that are absolutely creative and crazy, over the top, that I feel like this is very oddly tame, you know, compared to the rest of the game. And I don't know exactly what I was expecting, but it just, I don't know, something more interesting than that. Regardless, even with an ending that isn't quite up to par with the rest of the game, I still had so much fucking fun with Bully. From the funny dialogue, to the while repetitive, still pretty catchy music, to the great missions, to the cool locations, and so on and so on. I absolutely love Bully. I did encounter one glitch throughout my playthrough, which was this one mission where I had to kill rats in the library. 10 out of the 20 of them kind of just stayed in one location, just like one on top of the other, and I was able to kill them really easily, like half of them, because they were kind of glitched in one spot. Other than that, it was a pretty smooth experience, and I'd recommend anyone to pick up and play this game. It's probably my favorite Rockstar game, but to be fair, it's like the only one I've actually beaten. It's a game that I could genuinely see myself go back to and play more of the side content because it's also a lot of damn fun. Overall, I'm going to give Bully a great, hilarious game with a surprising amount of variety of things to do with a kind of rushed final few moments, but hey, I could pull the fire alarm in the dorm and beat up everyone while they try to run out. Isn't that great? Out of 10. Again, I loved it. I had so much goddamn fun with this game. Honestly, if it came out this year, it would be very high up on my game of the year list. Like, it may be game of the year. I loved it. I had so much fucking fun with it. And to make a full circle out of this whole controversy, I just want to say that when you actually play Bully, you realize you aren't playing a bully. Jimmy is genuinely trying to stop people from fighting. Yes, he's doing it in a dick way, and he's in a way fighting to stop fighting. But it's entertainment. It's a video game. What do you want to have a video game where you talk to people about peace? The fuck is that? That's not even a game. That's just an audiobook. The fuck is that? It just goes to show how ignorant people can be blaming things like video games on real life situations, which sadly still happens today. and they don't kind of look at the bigger picture or even the tiny picture. They don't look at it. They just see the word bully. They see Grand Theft Auto and they think, oh my God, this is going to cause shootings or whatever. And it's just like, really? Like, it's rated T for teen. You're sure you're punching people, but you have a skateboard. You don't even drive a car. You can't kill anyone. You know, there's nothing that's really bad about it. You know, you shoot people with a slingshot. People love to cause drama, and people love controversy, and that's just what it is, and that's the world we live in. But that'll be it for today. I really, really damn hope that Rockstar makes a Bully 2. I'd honestly much rather prefer that over GTA 6. I really would. I had so much fun with it, and I hope so. They make a Bully 2. We need one.
I heard a rumor Bully 2 is coming.
Oh, yeah? Where?
I was told.
By who?
Can't say names. They just told me they heard a rumor, so there's a rumor Bully 2 is coming.
So, it's a rumor of a rumor.
Yes?
Well, damn. It must be true, then. So, yeah. That was episode 3 of Back of the Backlog. I had so much fun with the game. Again, I loved it. Yeah, you know, maybe some of the final few missions weren't up to par, but what are you gonna... That's kind of almost nitpicking in a way when it's of some missions compared to the other 30 that you played that are so damn good. You know, I absolutely had so much fun with it. I really did. And I can't wait for an eventual Bully 2. And so yeah, guys. Let me know down in the comments what you thought. Please share this because it's a lot of time to do this video. Oh my God. But yeah, have you played Bully? What'd you think of it? Let me know down in the comments below. And I'll see you guys next time. Bully was a fucking awesome game, but it's officially out of the backlog. Dear Robert, I'm sure you've been wondering why I haven't contacted you this whole past month. Or maybe you don't wonder, because to be honest, I don't blame you if you didn't. I was a huge dick to both Niffler and you. For that, I apologize. This past month, I've been alone. Trying to understand why I am like I am. With that, I've looked at our past videos, and I get tears in my eyes. I don't want to lose you as a friend.
You've been there for me for a while now, and I want to continue to be there for you. I got a game for you to show how truly sorry I am. I personally love the game. I know you haven't played a lot of this franchise. Hope you enjoy it. If you don't, that's fine too. I won't argue. I've learned to listen and hope you forgive me. I'll call you sometime soon. Hope you pick up. Thank you.
Because if you need me, I'll be there.